What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Luvseat, shout it, coming at y'all with another video today, man. This will be my first tutorial, man. I figured I'd help some folks out today, man. I'm feeling generous, you know what I'm saying? So today I'm gonna be showing y'all how to add a soundtrack to your Unity game. For the last 5 months, I've been working on my own boxing game called Bloody Knuckles. If you haven't seen any of my previous devlog videos on that video game, I'll definitely leave a link so you guys can check that out and get caught up on the progress. The demo will be out soon. So in the process of making this game, I got the idea that I wanted to make a soundtrack so y'all can have some nice music to listen to while y'all knocking niggas out, you know what I'm saying?
Yo, this is MC Wizardry. I stay cold-hearted cause I'm a lizard G, spitting and dropping these lyrics hard as Godzilla's knee, shedding and switching my colors like I'm disloyal B. I slap a T-Rex in his face, don't battle royal me.
And I couldn't find any videos on YouTube concerning making a soundtrack. They were always about using one song. So I had to do a little bit of game devving and figure out how to make a soundtrack myself. And for as simple as a concept that it is, it's really not that simple. You know, we get on the computer every day, we turn on Spotify, we turn on YouTube, and we'll tell it to put on a playlist, and we'll click shuffle, and it'll shuffle by itself. But what people don't realize is, as developers, we are the ones who have to tell the program what to shuffle and how to shuffle it. So today, I'm going to share with y'all how I figured it out myself so that you don't have to do the hard work that I had to do. So without further ado, let's get to some coding, man. For the sake of this video, I created myself a sample project with two separate scenes. That way, we'll be able to transport the soundtracks between scenes without the music player stopping. First thing you want to do is put together a playlist of however many songs you want. Make sure they're MP3 files and import them into your Unity project. Create a folder for the soundtrack and drop those songs into that folder. Now we're going to create an empty game object called Music Manager. We're going to add an audio source to it and make sure you deselect Play on Awake and add a script to it called Music Manager. Open up your script and we're going to make a private audio source. Name it whatever you want. We're going to make an audio clip array to hold the songs and we're going to add a float for the volume. Go to the start method and get a reference to the audio source by using get component audio source. Now we're going to go down and create a method called change song with an int parameter for song. Inside of that method, we're going to set the audio source clip to one of the songs inside of the array. And we're going to pass in our int song to choose a song when this method is called. Then we're going to call the play method from the audio source. Now we're going to go up to void update and set the audio source volume to the volume float that we created in the beginning. Now we're going to go up under that and create an if statement to call chain song with a random value for the int song if the source isn't playing. We're also going to add this if statement to the start function as well. Now we're going to go back to Unity and populate our array with the songs that we chose. Now we're going to press play, and you should hear a random song out of your array. Everything should be working perfectly now, but if you're working with an older version of Unity, let's say 2019 or below, the audio source will not play the next song because it doesn't know that the song is over yet. That leads us into phase two. So now we're going to go back to our script and create a float for track timer. In the update method, we're going to create a new if statement that increments the track timer by 1 every second if the audio source is playing. Now we're going to go to the if statement that we previously created and add the condition or if track timer is greater or equal to audio source clip dot length. Now we're going to go back to our chain song method and we're going to set the track timer to 0 at the beginning so the timer resets each time this function is called. Now we're going to go back to Unity and press play. You'll see that the timer is counting now. I'm going to fast forward this video to the end of this song so that we don't have to sit here and listen to it. As you can see here, the song is about to end, and when it does, it's going to go to the next song, play the song, and it's going to reset the timer back to 0. Everything is working perfectly except for one more problem. Because we set the song number to a random value, Unity will pick any song that it wants to, meaning that it can play a song more than once before the others get played. We want to get every song to play once before it starts over and shuffles again. That brings us to phase 3. So now we're going to go back to our script again and create an int called songsPlayed and a bool array called beenPlayed. Now go down to the start method and set the bool array length to the length of the songs array. This way you don't have to always keep going back to edit it whenever you add or subtract the song from the songs array. Now we're going to go back down to our chain song method and we're going to increment songsPlayed by 1 every time this is called. We're also going to set our beenPlayed bool to true and pass in the parameter int song to correspond with the song that's currently being played. Then we're going to wrap all of this logic inside of an if statement that only gets called if the int song hasn't been played. Then we're going to close this logic with an else statement that calls stop on the audio source. What this is going to do is force chain song to be called again in our update method because the audio source is not playing. Now we're going to go back up to the update method and add an if statement to reset the shuffle if song play equals the song's array length. Inside of it, we're going to reset songs play to 0. Then we're going to create a for loop to increment I if I is less than the song array length. Inside of that for loop, we're going to create an if statement that breaks out of this loop if I equals the song array length. Then we're going to close off this logic with an else statement to set the beenPlayed bool to false and pass in I as the int for the song. And just for faster testing, we're going to go back to our else statement right here and we're going to add a button press so that we don't have to actually wait for the songs to end. We could just skip them. Now we're going to go back to Unity and press play. As you can see, we have a bool array for beenPlayed that matches the number of songs that are in our soundtrack. When a song gets played, the corresponding bool turns true. Once every song is played once, all of the bools return false, and the shuffle starts over again. Everything works perfectly now. So now all we got to do is a little bit of refactoring. So now we're going to go back to our script one last time. We're going to make beenPlayed, track timer, and songsPlayed invisible in the inspector because now we don't need to see them. Now we're going to go to update and take our restart shuffle logic and put it into its own method. Then we're going to replace it in the update method just to make update look a little bit cleaner. Now we're going to turn this script into a singleton. Create a private void awake and add the don't destroy on load functionality to it. Now we're going to go back to Unity and test it out. As you can see here, I have 2 separate scenes for this tutorial. Each scene has a button that's responsible for changing between scenes. And to prove that this is traveling in between scenes, I made both of the buttons look totally different. So we're going to press play. And as you can see, we're traveling in between scenes and the music is not being interrupted. You can also see here that the volume is adjustable in the inspector as well. There it is! Now you got a soundtrack in your game. At this point, you can just add or subtract songs out of your songs array as you please and it'll all work perfectly. Easy, right? No! It wasn't easy.
No!
I had to work for hours to figure this out. If only it was some way for y'all to pay me back for all this hard work that I did. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I wish YouTube had something like a like button that y'all could smash for me or something. You know what I'm saying? Just to help me out a little bit. You know what I'm saying?
Stupid.
that's it for the video, man. I hope y'all boys enjoyed it. Definitely hope it helped you out. If it did, please leave a like, man. It ain't gonna hurt you, man. Just hit the like button, dog. Hit it. Let me know what y'all think about it in the comment section, man. You know what I'm saying? If there's anything that you think I should have did different. No two people code the same, man. You know what I'm saying? This is just how I tackled it, and I'm interested to see how y'all would have tackled this situation, man. But anyway, it's your boy Luvseat Shawty, man. I'll see y'all boys in the next one. Peace. Couple bands, maybe took off in the socket. Ain't fucking chopper, I'ma hit him with a rocket. Nonsense. Senorita, help me come up on the profit. But the devils and the demons try to stop it. And you can hate me, but you loving how I rock it. Yeah. Do this nigga, man, no. Yeah, like he's sliding the man.